In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create this pretty cool slideshow template inside Adobe After Effects from scratch. Now, if you're a patron on my Patreon page, you can download this template for Adobe After Effects. It holds over 100 photos, which can be really helpful if you have a bunch of photos that you want to create an easy slideshow for. So if you're interested, feel free to go grab that in the link below. But otherwise, let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
All right, so I'm inside Adobe After Effects, and the first thing I'm gonna do is import my photos. So I'm gonna go to File, Import, File, and then I have some sample photos that I'm gonna import and use. For this tutorial, I'm only using 10 photos, but you may have more, so feel free to go and import your photos into After Effects. I'm gonna click Open. Now that we have our photos, the next thing I'm gonna do is create a new bin by clicking on this icon here, and I'm gonna name this Comps, short for Compositions. And now that we have our comps bin, what I'm going to do is create a new composition and make a placeholder for our photos. So to do that, I'm going to go up to composition, new composition, and I'm going to name this photo 1. And you can choose from the presets. If you want to make your template in 4K, you can choose 4K settings. But in this case, I'm going to choose 1920 by 1080 at 29.97 frames a second. And then for the duration, I'm going to change it to however long I want each photo to last. So in my template, I want each photo to remain on the screen for 10 seconds. So I'm going to leave it at 10 seconds and then click OK. Now that we have our first placeholder template, what I'm going to do is click on it inside the project panel and click Command D to duplicate it. And I'm going to do this for however many photos I have. So in this case, I'm going to duplicate it 10 times here. Now that I have 10 compositions, what I'm going to do is open the first one, untwirl the sample photos, and click and drag in the first one. I'm going to click S on my keyboard to bring up the scale property and just scale this down and reposition it accordingly into my composition here. Then I'm going to double click on composition photo 02 and then click and drag in the next photo. Once again, I'm going to click S and scale this down. And you basically just do this for every composition for however many photos you have here. I'm going to speed up this part of the process, and once I'm done, we'll continue here. All right, so I just finished the 10th photo, so you should have all your photos in here. The next step is to create another composition, and this will be our final slideshow animation. So to do that, I'm going to go up to composition, new composition, and I'm just going to name this final slideshow. And then for this, I'm going to choose the same settings I chose for the placeholders, so 1080 at 29 frames a second. And the duration this time, I'm going to change it to around maybe 5 minutes or so. It can be a little bit longer than however many photos you have. We can always trim this later. Next, I'm going to click OK. And now I'm going to select the first one, so photo 01, and then hold down Shift and select the last one here. And I'm going to click and drag these to the timeline panel here. They should all be in here. Once they're in here, select the first one, hold down Shift, select the last one, and then right click and go to Keyframe Assistant Sequence Layers. This will enable you to sequence them so they're not all on top of each other. And what I recommend doing is checking this overlap option and then changing the duration for however long you want your transition to be. So in this case, I want each transition to be 1 second long, so I'm going to change this to 1 second. And then I'm going to click OK. You'll notice here, if we zoom in by clicking and dragging this icon right here, we can zoom in and we see that we have a 1 second overhang between each of these photos. So during this point in time, that's going to be where we transition from photo 1 to photo 2. So first, what I'm going to do is animate this photo on. So I'm going to go at the very beginning of the composition here, and I'm going to click P on my keyboard to bring up the position property. Your values may or may not be separated. If they aren't, you can always right-click on them and go to Separate Dimensions. This allows us to animate the X and Y positions separately from each other. All right, so once we have that, what I'm going to do is animate the X position. So I'm going to make a keyframe by clicking on the stopwatch, and then I'm going to go out forward about 1 second. So right about there is good. And then I'm going to make a keyframe by clicking on this diamond. Then I'm going to go back to the first keyframe by clicking this back arrow. Then I'm going to click and drag this value to the left to slide it off. So when we click play on our spacebar, we can see that it animates on. Now we can spruce this up a little bit by adding some easing. So I'm going to right click on the last keyframe and go to Keyframe Assistant, Easy Ease In. And this eases into this keyframe. So now when we click and play this back, this just kind of goes to a nice steady stop. And you can adjust the easing by going into the graph editor here. And if we zoom in, we can click and drag while holding down Shift on this handlebar to the left to add some ease. So if we click and play this back, you can see we have a nice ease in animation there. And you can adjust this to however you want the easing to be. So that's how I want it. And we'll copy the same easing to the other keyframes. So I'm gonna exit the graph editor for now, and we can go to the end of our clip by clicking O on our keyboard to go to the end of the layer. And we can make another keyframe by clicking on this diamond here. And we wanna start animating it off right around the 9 second mark. So right around there, make a keyframe by clicking on the diamond and then click on the right arrow and then animate it off. So we're gonna animate it to the right, that way it animates off. And once again, we can add some easing. So I'm gonna right click on this first keyframe, go to keyframe assistant, easy ease out. Once again, go to the graph editor and you can adjust the keyframe easing by clicking and dragging on this handlebar here. So when we click and play this back, this is what we have. So it eases out nicely out of that keyframe. You can exit the graph editor. That'll be the last time we go in there. And if we zoom out, we can see we have our first animation for our first photo. Now we have to do the rest of the photos. So to do that, what I'm gonna do is click on the third photo here, click I to go to the beginning of the third photo, and then click on the second photo here, click P to bring up the position. And this time, what I'm gonna do is toggle on the Y position keyframe. So I'm gonna click on that stopwatch, click O on my keyboard to go to the end of the layer, and then I can animate this off by clicking and dragging this value. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit so we can see a little bit better. Now, one way that you can copy the easing is by using a plugin. So you'll notice that this has a nice ease out and we want to maintain that same transition for this keyframe here. What I like to do is use the free plugin by AE Juice called Copy Ease. I'll leave it down in the video description if you do want to download Copy Ease. You can see I have it docked down in the bottom right-hand corner. And you can see with a keyframe selected, what I can do is click the copy button and then click on this keyframe here and then click paste. And you'll notice that it pastes the same curve animation to that keyframe. So when we click and play this back, you can see we've copied that ease without having to try to manually add this back in using the graph editor. So we can keep using that for the rest of the keyframes here. So now that we have that, we can go to our next keyframe here. So I'm gonna click I on our keyboard to go to the next one, click on this, click P once again. Maybe this time we animate the X position, click O to go to the end, and we can slide this maybe to the left this time. And once again, we can click on this keyframe here and click paste. You'll notice that we animated this off. And that's basically the entire process. Once you get to the end, let's say if this is your last photo, if you need to trim the composition, you can click N on your keyboard to trim the workspace, and then right click on the workspace bar and go to trim comp to work area. This way, this trims the composition if you have leftover space. Now the next part would be to export this out. So if you want to see the best export settings, I will link that video right out there. Feel free to go check it out. But that does it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Reach out if you have any questions, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.